this whole expanse of almost 9 square kilometers came in the span of almost 14 years. The city was built very quickly, and then the population moved to the city in that period also. So as they were building, they were moving in. Of course, the palace part was already ready in 1580, and the city around it was built around 1585. It is reliably learnt that Akbar moved his capital from Agra to Fatehpur Sikri. So he actually shifted his capital from Agra to Fatehpur Sikri because he was so much moved by the prophecy of a saint. In his memoirs, he has mentioned that he went to the quarries and he quarried the stone himself. Also, he carried the stone. He carried the stone on his head and got it to sight. So he was a great monarch. So he made.
Weren't they heavy?
Yeah, but it was a motivation thing. He didn't have to carry a large stone. He would carry a small stone, but to motivate his team. Like leadership. Yeah. I mean, he would not carry the stone all the way from quarry to the site. And then there were many palaces built alongside. For example, this building on the left. This building on the left looks double storied from outside. So when you go inside, you will see a large column made of sandstone, on top of which we have a circular seat, and there are passages running from that seat into the four corners, also into the sides. This is where Akbar would sit in the center with his council of ministers, and he would address all the issues concerning the politics, concerning the military, concerning the social milieu. Akbar also formed a faith based on the dynamism of Hinduism, Islam, Buddhism, Jainism, and Christianity put together. Hinduism, Islam, Buddhism, Jainism, and Christianity put together. So he would invite discussions from scholars from various religions. Very few times when you marry religion and politics, they work. And it worked in Akbar's time. That was his quality. That was his quality of leadership. Looking to our right, you see the 5-storied palace. It was used for the royal family, for the military officers, for the nobles, for the concubines, and for ordinary people. So you can see in one large hall, he was inviting everybody. Never before this had happened. So he was a very inclusive monarch. Akbar also had a Hindu wife. So he followed a lot of Hindu traditions. So every day in the morning when he was here, he would go on top of the building. He would cup his hands and ask somebody to put water in it. And at sunrise, he would offer water to the sun god, which is an ancient Hindu practice, that we offer water to the sun god, asking for the blessings. Bharat knows about it, that we ask, offer water to the sun every morning. And we also do a chanting alongside. So in many ways, he had adopted the lifestyle of the local people of his empire. And that's how he could consolidate his empire.